Hi, I'm Ken Lauterbach. David.
Thank you so much for taking care of her all these years. I know that's been a labor of love for you, and our community really appreciates you.
It still runs, drives, pumps. There are some things I want to show you about it, obviously.
Today, an antique fire engine begins its journey back to the home of its original owner, the city of Paris.
No.
Paris, Tennessee.
It's about 2,208 miles from Paris, Tennessee Fire Department to here.
Oui.
The American LaFrance engine was purchased by the city in 1928 for $12,500. There, it served its community until 1964.
High school football games many years ago, when our team scored, the bell from this fire engine rang.
After being sold a couple times, it eventually ended up with the Curtis family of Portland, Oregon. And in 2016, they donated it to Tualatin Valley Fire and Rescue.
Come on, baby.
And now, more than 90 years later, TVFR is donating the engine back to the city that first bought it.
I'm thrilled. The community of Paris, Tennessee, I think has already fallen in love with the fire engine from the pictures, and our community is anxious for it to come back home.
I think it'll be awesome, which I love old cars. I've always had something to do with them, and be nice to look at and see back home and running around.
This is the exhaust manifold side.
Over the years, TVFR volunteer Ken Lauterbach has worked to restore many antique fire engines, including this American LaFrance.
When you adjust the chains, then you have to go back and adjust all the brake linkage because you've changed the length.
He's a walking encyclopedia of antique fire engine knowledge. For Ken, though, saying goodbye to an old friend is bittersweet.
This one has always been one of my favorites. It's fun to drive. It's loud, it runs well, it goes fast. It doesn't stop well, but it goes fast. However, I have to separate my personal feelings from my professional feelings, because I'm also a firm believer that if a community wants to preserve their own history, they should be given the opportunity to do that.
But in the end, he knows there's always new things on the horizon.
Since I've been doing this antique fire engine restoration since I was about 16, and I'm 67 now, I kind of always have my ear to the ground looking for things and trying to find more apparatus for us. So yes, this one's leaving us, but we have hope that there will be others in the future that join us.